The long gun lance, outside of maybe spread or sticky bow guns, really might be the most comfy weapon you can possibly build around. The introduction of Saffy took this to the next level. You were able to eliminate a piece of the required Zora set necessary to get Artillery Secret. In fairness, the Zora set really isn't that bad in terms of long gun lance, but being able to replace one of those pieces with whatever you want is incredible in terms of QOC, or quality of comfiness. So now that we have a souped up long gun lance with the Zora essence in 2 level 4 slots, how can we even get better? Well, that depends partially on your thoughts on a specific skill, Evade Extender. Now, you guys know I'm absolutely in love with the skill and preach its glory to all who are willing to be blessed by its touch. I put it on just about every weapon that I can. The amount of mobility it gives you cannot be appreciated enough, but I don't expect people to understand that because if a skill doesn't directly add to your damage count, people will feel guilty or say that you're wasting a space for it. When it comes to long gun lance though, I absolutely won't budge on Evade Extender. Maxing out that hop distance is key to me, especially how I play. The introduction of Arch-Tempered Nami brought with it an armor set that is overall pretty meh, but there is one piece that really caught my eye immediately, and that is the waist. It has a maxed out evade extender and 2 points of recovery speed with another 2 level 2 slots to work with as well. Admittedly, I don't really care that much for recovery speed. If it also applied and synergized with the Val set bonus, it'd be another story. Regardless, I surely won't scoff at the fact that you get 2 points of it as well. With long gun lance, you need 2 things to max out your DPS, Artillery 5 and Focus 3. Literally everything else is your preference and how you want to play. For me, there are skills that I definitely consider must-haves with my comfy set. Health boost is clearly a must. For me, this also extends to recovery up and evade extender. With the Nami waist, this unlocks so many viable routes. If you want to go with the slinger capacity secret, you can absolutely do that and still have your evade extender ready to go with an abundance of slots left to build towards your preferences. Or if there's another 2-piece set bonus that you want to go after, you can absolutely do that. I went with a different route. I took the Silver Wrath legs for some extra time on our worm stake and even opening up for double wall slams if that's your thing. For the last remaining piece, I went with the Vow Gloves for that sweet recovery up that synergizes well with our 2 health augments. So once we fill out health boost and recovery up, which can be very easily done through combo decos, and finish out that final artillery point, we are literally free to put whatever we want in our build. You don't get more comfy than Guard 5, so of course I throw that into my charm slot. But if you're a hop lance enthusiast, you really could not be in a better position. You can strip off that guard and throw an evade window instead, and you'll have all the iframes you could ask for while having your debilitated shield as a last resort. I stuck with Guard 5 of course, but I'll definitely be trying to get better with hop lance now that I have all of this extra space. This time I took a way different route, so I took every chance I could to throw in some physique in there and gave myself a reason to use my physique plus decos. Why? Because there's literally very few things that are left to slot in that will further benefit you with long gun lance. Physique will help cut down on all the stamina that's used to use those extended hops. You could also slot in stamina surge if you want to get back that used stamina for blocking even faster. You get where I'm getting at though, right? It's gotten to the point where we're splitting hairs between physique and stamina surge, and that's just talking in a sense of a build that would get general use. If we start to talk about building towards specific encounters, you can truly see the power and the comfiness. You can easily slot in a hard resistance to build up your element resistance to the monster you're facing and feel absolutely zero guilt in doing so. And just with a couple switches of decorations, you can have anti-builds for whatever monsters. Like right here, anti-Namiel, anti-Teostra, and anti-Valhazak. You could even use the extra space to put in blight resistance. If you're the type that doesn't like to use your shield to block through a roar, use that extra space to build up your earplugs and enjoy the impenetrable force of Guard 5 and earplugs. The possibilities are truly endless. And please don't come at me with long gun lance not doing enough damage, because we already know that's definitely not the case. Get better with gun lance and enjoy the spoils of an unlimited number of possibilities in your build. But that's gonna be it for this one. If you enjoy not dying ever, take a second to get a Saffy long gun lance souped up and ready to go. Don't take the build I threw up there as the gospel, because the point is to show how much space and freedom you have to make the build your own, while still having all the comfiness and damage a long gunlance can enjoy. Patreon and Discord info is in the description below, so feel free to join our community on Discord. If you like the video, please do let me know with a thumbs up. Comment below what you would do with all that extra space, and feel free to let us know what your build consists of. Subscribe and hit the bell if you haven't already for more Iceborne, Monster Hunter, and other gaming content. Dudes forever, have a good night, and happy hunting.